Welcome, everyone. My name is Steve Halasnik, and I'm co-founder and managing partner of Financing Solutions. Financing Solutions is a leading provider of lines of credit to small businesses. Our line of credit program is fast, easy, inexpensive, and costs nothing to set up, making it a great cash backup plan for your business. If you'd like to learn more about our line of credit program, please visit us at fscreditline.com. That's FS as in Financing Solutions, creditline.com, or give us a call at 862-207-4118. And just remember, the time to set up your line of credit is when you don't need it, so that when you do need it, you have it all ready to go. And today, I am very excited to be speaking with a friend of mine that I've known for over 20 years, Joe Mindak. And Joe is the president of The Connective. And The Connective is an elite community of subject matter experts, entrepreneurs, and connectors that exist to unlock access to the invaluable relationships and resources that entrepreneurs need to build, sustain, and grow their business. So just to put it in a summary, The Connective is really made to help everybody who's in The Connective help each other with, in many cases, with leads and helping them to grow their businesses. It helps them with other things as well. And Joe will get into that a little bit. But Joe, I'd like to welcome you to today's Entrepreneur MBA podcast.
Awesome, Steve. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it. I'm excited to chat.
Sure. So today's topic, you know, it's something that I always knew I could be good at. It's always something that I thought was very, very important. And it's the first thing I always turn to when I'm looking for answers or solutions is the power and skill of people networking. And, you know, the reason why I asked Joe to come on today is, you know, a couple of things about Joe that you guys should know, our listeners should know, is that Joe is one of the most giving people that I have ever met. He is someone who never expects anything in return, but is always willing to give out help to anybody else. It doesn't have to be professional. It could be just there's a charity. There is someone who's in need. He is the most generous person I have ever been in contact with. And, you know, here's an example of somebody who takes something that he's just naturally good at it and makes it into a business. And that's Joe's ability to network with other people, which just comes incredibly natural to Joe. So Joe, did you always recognize that you were good at this, at networking with other people?
You know, probably not when I was younger. Like none of us know what we're going to do, but I was always going to be, and my friend Amy always said this to me when I was in college, she's like, you're either going to be a salesperson or a politician. So, yeah, you know, I guess those two aren't the best professions out there, and the two of the sleaziest. But you know, it's that you know, always being able to talk to people and get along with anybody, and then just, you know, bring people together, right? So I've always been able to, like, I've been the one that always, hey, let's get this thing together, let's throw a party together, or let's run an event, or let's do that. How do we get all these people and together in the same room? And then it just naturally things flow from there, and people meet each other, or you know, or connect in business and all that. So, but I really started to learn how, like, what really networking was, right? You don't really know what it was when you're young. Yeah. You're just like, hey, Steve, you should meet my friend Gina. And then all of a sudden you guys get married, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But like when I started my first business, I was introduced to a guy named Jay Shevins. And Jay invited me to this thing called B&I. And I was like, what is this? You know, so B&I is Business Networking International, or Business Networking, whatever it's called. But it's the largest networking group in the world, right? There's, I think, 220,000 members in the U.S. that are part of this network. And B&Is are in every town you look in, there's a B&I network. And basically, they're there to introduce each other to the people and get deals, right? So I joined the group with Jay, and I started to learn how to network and then actually do it aggressively and actually, you know, start to listen when people are asking for things, or to start to identify, oh, Steve said he's looking for someone to build a website. Oh, you know what? Steve, I have somebody. Because you have a lot of conversations now with clients and people and everything, and they're just talking. And it just, you know, oh, that's great, Steve, you're looking for a website. And everyone else would just let it pass. I'm like, wait, what'd you say? Let me take that and try and, you know, network with somebody. So So I learned really how to network through that introduction from Jay, and then through BNI over the years. Just you start to network because that's what you do in a group. Your role is to bring referrals in, and you do it.
Yeah.
And then that's how I started the Connective. Right, I became a connector, and I enjoyed doing it. I realized that I love doing it, and I still love connecting people just for the pure art of connecting. And I love, like you said, yes. Do I give a lot of stuff? Yes, I always enjoyed giving to charity or giving to people. I do it all. But now I do say, hey, I'm going to give you something, but you're going to give me a little something back for it. That's what the Connective is doing, because we charge a commission, right? And after all these years of making great introductions and people making great money off it, it's like, hey, I'm going to provide a service to the people who are looking for somebody good, right? Because, you know, if you go on LinkedIn and you say, I'm looking for a website designer, everybody and their mother is like, hey, this person. But that doesn't mean it's the right fit for what you're looking for. So I've tried to help clients and different people say, listen, all right, you're looking for a website? Great. What platform? What's the website going to do, right? You can't just throw it on WordPress or Joomla or any other, any other platform. It depends on what you're trying to do with the website. Is it an e-commerce site? Do you want Magento? So like I tried to figure out, what is it you need? What's your budget? You know, what's your goals on this thing? And, oh, okay, now that I have all that, these couple companies that I've worked with before are going to be a good fit for you to get what you need done, right? Because what happened in the past when I owned my marketing company, people come to me after, oh, I just spent $50,000 with Steve Elastic's company and they didn't build anything I wanted and it took too long and it doesn't even do what I want to do. Can you help me fix it? Yeah, I can help you fix it. Oh, by the way, we don't have any money left anyway. So like people are getting screwed left and right by just, you know, not really knowing who they're going after. So
yeah. So did you start getting in? It's BMI, BMI.
Is that N as in Nancy? BNI.
BNI. Okay. So that's right. It makes sense. Networking, right? That's the N. Yep. So did you start getting involved in BNI? You've had a number of businesses prior to the Connective. Did you get involved in BNI after those businesses or early on in your career?
Early on, you know, I started in the printing business, you know, with my father. And, you know, it was like a way to get business. And BNI works really well locally, right? It's a local chapter type of thing. So, you know, we were in Englewood and I met a lot of business owners in Englewood. And again, it does teach you how to network as well. And anyone that's trying to grow business on a local level, I would suggest joining a BNI, right? It does what it's supposed to do to a certain extent, right? So at that point, I was selling business cards and letterheads and, you know, stuff like that and getting some introductions. And then when I started getting more into the marketing side of things, building digital platforms and digital marketing programs, like it kind of took a little level up from what BNI might be able to introduce me to. Because, you know, you're getting introduced to, you know, the local dentist that wants a website for $1,000 or something like that, which is fine, right? Again, for someone that's a small agency doing websites, there's tons of people out there doing websites for $500,000, $1,500. That's perfect. But for what I wanted to do, and that's why one of the reasons I started the Connective was we want to do stuff up here. We want to do $100,000 websites. You know, my last website I sold at my agency was $650,000. You know, you're not going to do that type of stuff in a local setting, right? So really when I started networking was then and doing a BNI, and then I learned how to do it better and better and better. And then I said, you know what, there's a better way to do this for what I'm looking to do. And that's what the Connective started.
So the Connective is also a much larger ticket item as well. I know you're mentioning, you know, you're doing some deals now that are in the millions.
So what the Connective was about was, look, BNI works to a certain extent, but you know, again, it's very local and the deals are only going to be a certain amount. And not to say that you're not going to get connected to somebody that's going to introduce you to somebody on a big deal, right? I had big deals that I did through BNI, but it was few and far between. And the other problem with the BNI, and again, it's not a problem, but it's a membership group, right? So if you pay your membership dues, you're going to get in, right? Like and they make money off of membership. So yes, it works and it brings business in, but they're pretty much going to accept, you know, 90% of the people that apply to become there because they're making money off of a membership model. That's their model. And with the Connective, I didn't want to just let everybody in the group because there was a lot of times at BNI, there was, you know, 30 people in the group, 10 of them did all the referrals, 10 tried to do some referrals, and 10 people were there because their boss told them to be there and that they should be in a networking group.
Yeah.
Right. So with the Connective, I don't care who you are or what kind of money you have. You're not getting in unless I talk to you and you're vetted out, you're introduced by somebody. I started with just people I knew and I trusted and invited to the group. And then from there, they invite other people in, and I have to vet those people out. And, you know, I vet them out by meeting them, talking to them, doing some research on them. You know, they're invited by somebody. But even if they get in the group to begin with, and then they're not coming to meetings and they're not doing what they're supposed to, I just ask them to leave. You know, I just asked somebody to leave a couple weeks ago. It wasn't coming to meetings, and it's fine. It doesn't make them a bad person or anything, but I need you there, right? And this won't work unless you're there and you're focused and you're sitting on that call, listening to the people that are presenting, right? Because
yeah,
you got to learn what they do so that you can refer them. You know, and the other reason I started the Connected was because LinkedIn, which works tremendously, right? Again, LinkedIn has all great things. But what was happening, every time I go on LinkedIn and be like, hey, Steve, can you connect me to, you know, Keith Giovanoli or whatever? He'd be like, all right, Joe, you know, we're connected on LinkedIn, but I don't know you. You know, we met at some function like 6 months ago. Like, I'm not going to open up my Rolodex to you that I don't, you know, I don't know if you do good work. I don't know who you are, really. I don't know if you're a good person. And people just wouldn't do it. There's no incentive to introduce you, right? Unless, you know, you knew somebody. So now I put the incentive. It's a monetary incentive. You introduce me to Keith and there's a deal that comes through. You're going to make a commission on that.
Yeah.
So, you know, that was getting back to, like you said, giving. Yeah, we give, but it's like, I'm going to give you this lead, but you're going to pay a commission. So everybody in the Connective agrees to pay a certain commission back to the group, you know, and then I split that commission. Whoever makes the introduction in the group gets 50% of that deal.
Yeah.
So yeah, the deals are, you know, generally bigger deals. I mean, they're not all huge deals. But, you know, we just closed a deal that was $23,000. You know, there's another deal on the table for like 18 grand. There's another deal for 25. There's deals like that. And then there's other deals. There was a proposal put out last week for about $250,000. And we have two deals on the table for, you know, one's for $2.3 million a year for the next 3 years, right? So there's, we're getting into, you know, listen, we want to be introduced to companies. So we're dealing with companies like UBS and Ernst & Young and Jaguar and like a lot of different, you know, bigger brands that could do that. And it's not all that, right? We're looking at medium-sized companies, but we're kind of staying away from really smaller companies because it's just not what our
yeah, yeah.
is, right?
So. What do you think that – so if you were to teach someone who doesn't, you know, hasn't really done much networking, what would you kind of – tell them, you know, how is a good way to network?
Well, you know, everyone just, you know, you go to all these networking events and people just think getting cards and blasting emails out after that is good, or getting as many connections as you can on LinkedIn is great, and then just blasting out stuff to them. You have to build relationships, right? If you don't have a relationship with somebody, they're still not going to want to connect you. Even if I tell you I'm going to give you 10 grand to make an introduction, you still, if you don't really know me, you don't like me, that, you know, you have a bad feeling, like you're not going to make just an introduction because you know somebody. So a lot of people go to these networking events and just like, hey, how you doing, Steve? What do you do? Like, that's not the way to introduction. Hey, Steve, tell me something about yourself. What are your interests? Oh, you're into hiking? Oh, let's talk about hiking. That's cool. Like, I like that too. Like, and then you start to just build a relationship with that person and get to know them a little bit. Like, you're not going to get to know everything. And then, you know, follow up with them. They seem like a good person to connect with, you know. And it doesn't always have to be in your business, right? Everyone's like, oh, I only talk to marketing people. No, you don't know who Steve Halastic knows. That could make an introduction to you at some point. So it's about building relationships and that giving, like you said. Like, yes, I've always, like in Hoboken, I've always told my wife this. Like, I was in Hoboken for 22 years. I owned a business there. I owned a magazine there. Like, I tried to make sure everything I did, you know, I did a lot of charity work. I did a lot of things. But I tried to make sure anytime I dealt with anyone in business, whatever, you always do the right thing, because you never know when that stuff's going to come back to you, right?
Yeah.
Like even now, like my wife and I was telling you before, we're selling this furniture and this and that. And, you know, I sold somebody a piece of furniture and they're like, I need paint. I'm like, well, just come and pick up. I have extra paint if you want to touch it up. I'll leave it out on the doorstep for you. She's like, why are we doing it? I said, because it's our reputation we're building, you know?
Yeah.
You don't know somewhere down the line if that person's like going to be selling their house and I have a real estate license, they'd be like, oh, we should use Joe. Well, that guy, he never even, you know, got back to us when we asked for extra pay. Something so small and simple. But next time, I'm like, oh, yeah, he was nice, so nice enough to just go out and give us that extra paint. You don't have to go pay 20 bucks for a gallon of paint. Like, the point is, like, there's things that you do in the beginning when you're networking and building relationships with people that, you know, can come back to either bite you in the ass or really be there later on. So, like, I'll give you – I met – with two people this year. One of the things I wanted to do is go through my LinkedIn and be like, let me just reconnect with a bunch of people. Like, there's people on my LinkedIn that I haven't talked in a while. So I literally went through one by one who I got to connect with, you know. And a lot of people I took invitations long ago, I took them, but some people are like, oh, I haven't talked to so-and-so in a while. Let me just give them a call. So two of the people I talked to, I hadn't talked to, one in like 3 years, one in like 10 years. Like, I didn't even remember how I met one of the guys, but he was like, you know, Joe, you hired me when I was starting my company. Uh-huh. And you paid me when I needed money to do something. And I never forgot that. And the other kid was the same way when he had started a company about 3 years ago. He's like, I don't know if I ever told you this, Joe, but I just wanted to thank you again for what you did back then. People remember that. So like now those two people I'm talking to again, and one of them works for a very large company that can bring, he's like, listen, we don't do $2 million deals. He's like, it's too small for our company. You know, he works at a big consulting firm. He's like, we don't do $2 million deals. We don't take. So there's one of the members in the connective that is perfect for what he's looking to do. And he's like, yeah, I'll just pass that along to them. So look at what I did 10 years ago and come back in dividends now because of doing the right thing back then. And just, you know.
Yeah, you know, I can be really, really good at networking. And the thing that always, there's a couple of things that I know to be true. Number one is, when I want to get answers, I find that I get better answers by calling the people I know and who might have a specialty in that area instead of looking on the internet. In the internet, I get a lot of crap, yeah. You know, but when I reach out to somebody, you know, if I want to learn something about network, I'm going to call you, right? If I'm going to, you know, if I want to know something about finance, I call Keith, right? You know, it's just all these different other people that are experts because they cut through all the crap that the internet gives you and really gives you the real world experience. That's number one. Number two is this concept always sticks in my head of 6 degrees of separation. And that's the idea that you can get to anybody in the world through 6 other people. And, you know, not calling 6 separate people, maybe calling, you know, calling Joe and asking you, who do you know that can do this? And then you refer me to somebody else and then they refer me to somebody else. Maybe that's, you know, a way to do it, or saying, I need to get to this person, the CEO of this company. How can I get to that person? You keep working it through. So that's the second thing that really always keeps me going is when if I want to get to this, I can get through to these different people. And then the third thing is how, you know, just powerful and fun it is to have friends in the, you know, various different industries. You know, we're all on computers constantly, and we're all working remotely, which is going to look like it. A lot of that might be continuing. You know, it's, you know, getting on a video call with a friend that I've known for 25 years, or, you know, even just kind of shooting the breeze with somebody and getting to know people again, keeping us human. I mean, would you agree with all those kind of comments?
Yeah. I mean, that's what I started doing with my LinkedIn. Like I was just saying before, is like, just, you know, I'm not calling anyone to be like, what kind of business you got for me? Right. Cause nobody wants that call from their college roommate, like from 20 years ago, hey man, you want to buy insurance? You know, I'm selling insurance now. You're like, well, you haven't talked to me in 20 years and now you're just calling for that. But I just started calling people like, hey, what's going on? What are you up to? Like, I'm speaking to an old friend today. I haven't talked to her in a while. I'm like, hey, you know what? I spoke to so-and-so, you know, you and I should talk. We haven't talked in a while. Let's just talk. And a lot of times it'll turn into something, but sometimes it's just good to just reconnect with some people. Right.
So, well, Yeah. I mean, I was amazed. So, Joe, I had 2 instances where I recently used LinkedIn, and I don't really use LinkedIn that much. And I had 2 instances. One of them was I was trying to help my son Mike get a internship he's 20, he's at college. And you know, first thing I did is I showed him how I was doing. But then he was striking out a little bit. So I said, okay, let me go into LinkedIn. And I reached out to all of the people who knew people. I didn't reach out to them, but I reached into their contacts, which it was pretty easy to do. to find people who are working in artificial intelligence, because that's the specialty that my son's going into. And it was pretty easy. I mean, because a lot of people who work at AI companies or have AI companies have .AI at the end of their URLs, which stands for artificial intelligence. And so I was able to do a search within LinkedIn for people with .AI and then reach out to them. And when I reached out to them in the text message, I told them how I got to them. Yeah. Right. And I said, I know this person, you are friendly with them. You know, my son is a junior at Boston University, blah, 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 blah. Right. He got 4 interviews. I mean, almost 90% of the people that I contacted, and we're talking maybe about 30 people, right? They all got back to me, which was amazing, you know? And I was like, wow, LinkedIn is incredibly powerful, because I had never really used it that much before.
Yeah, so well, that's what LinkedIn is. It is networking, and it's all about who you know. Nobody's reinvented the wheel. It's always been about who you know. Talk to a sales guy that's 90 years old now, and when he used to sell back in 1940, it was all about who you know and who could introduce you, right? My wife just threw out her Syracuse book from like 1995. It was a big, thick book we used to get from college, and I remember I had mine from Dayton. And you go through that book and, you went to that school? Yeah, I'll connect with you. Like, even that's what happens now. You go on LinkedIn and look up people went to University of Dayton. Like, if I lead with, hey, I went to UD, most of the time they're going to talk to me. Now, whether they'll introduce me or not, maybe, maybe not. But, like, I just talked to a kid that's a couple years out of school doing finance out in Ohio somewhere. He's like, hey, I went to UD. I'd love to talk. And him and I have been chatting, right? And I'm not using him. I'm like, look, it's not for me. I already have someone doing my stuff. But, like, it was great that he reached out and And you know what? We talked about 3 months ago, and he was great, really professional. I was very impressed by him. He got to me through UD, through that. And then just recently, it was funny because I was going to introduce him to a friend of mine that runs a finance company. I was like, Chris, you should talk to this kid. I was really impressed with him. I just, you know, when you find someone like that, and I just wanted to connect to him because I enjoy connecting. The other day, Chris sent a note. Hey, you know anyone looking for a job? We're hiring. And I was like, you know what? I was going to – so I reached out to this kid, and I was like, hey, man, listen, you looking for a job? He wasn't. He's like, I'm happy where I am, which is great too. But like
– he knows somebody.
Yeah, or whatever it is. So it's like you never know. And then another friend of mine posted, I don't know, about 6 months ago, hey, I'm looking for a job for my son, just graduated engineering, whatever. I was like, hey, you know what? I'm looking for someone to do some engineering for this project I was working on. But let me see if I connect him. And I wound up – just timing-wise, connecting him to this guy in town, really nice guy that owns an architectural firm. They do everything. They do the engineering, the architecture, the build-out, everything. And it's right in town where he lives. It's like the dream job for this guy. The company is awesome. Their headquarters are really cool. Like, it's a great place to work. And everyone's really – he's loving it. He's got his dream job. And because his dad posted on LinkedIn, right? So, you know, if you're not using LinkedIn, you know, to get to people – I don't know what, you know, why people wouldn't be. I mean, you say you're not using a lot, but like, it's going to get you to see who knows somebody, right?
Yeah.
And then it's a matter again. Then my problem with LinkedIn was sometimes it was like somebody doesn't want to introduce you, but for me to call you, like, you know, Keith. Yeah, I've known Keith for 20 years. I could call him on right today. That's where it works, and that's what we do with the connective. It's like, listen, if someone in the connective wants to make an introduction, I say, see if you know that person well. Like, I don't really know them that well. I used to work with them back in the day. I'll reach out though. I'm like, no, don't even bother. It's because they're not going to respond. Right? They're not. Unless you know that person really well, we could text them or call them on their cell phone. That's the type of relationship you want. And then ask them if there's something, if you can make the introduction, right? I tell everyone in Connective, don't force the meeting, right? Hey, Steve, can you meet with this guy? He wants to, you know, talk to you about insurance. You're like, yeah, Joe, I'll meet your friend. Like, that's how things used to happen and still do. And people want to just make that. Okay, I'll have it. But there's no reason to have the meeting. Or I'll call up and be like, hey, Steve, listen, I got a guy that's selling insurance. He wants to talk to you. You know, say, oh, you know what, Joe? We actually, you know what, Keith and I were just talking about E&O insurance. I'd like to talk to him. Good. Yeah. Then we make the introduction. So the way it works well, and this was one of the things with what was happening with BNI and other groups, was people just wanted to be on a referral board. Like, you get your name every month. Who passed out the most referrals, right? People would be like, hey, oh, I know a business owner, Steve, go call him. You'd be like, hey, Steve, Keith told me to give you a call. You know, I sell insurance. Can I talk to you about insurance? You'd be like, we're fully insured and my brother does insurance and I go get it through him. So I don't know why we're even having this conversation. Like, I waste your time. I waste my time. I waste it just to get on the board, on the leaderboard of most referrals passed out. So the way we're doing with Connective is like, look, it has to be someone you know well, and it has to be someone that wants to talk to you about whatever you're selling.
Wow, that's good.
If they don't, then don't do it, right? I asked a guy, a friend of mine from college, is president of Cutco, you know, the knife company. And I reached out. I said, listen, you know, one of the guys in my group does virtual call centers. Jim, is it okay if I, do you want to talk to him about it? He goes, no, you know what, Joe? Part of our structure is that we only hire people in the Rochester area or wherever he was in upstate New York. We want to hire local people and get back to the community. Good, fine. He's like, well, can't you just ask him to meet? No, I'm like, I'm not going to ask him. He said, that's your thing. They're not interested. You don't push a meeting on someone just to have a meeting. And that's just the way we got to do it, and the way it should be done. Instead of forcing these meetings, it's just a waste of time for everybody. Yeah, when I make that introduction, it's like, hey, here's my college roommate. And yes, Steve, he wants to buy what you're selling. And always happen, but it's a much better close rate if it does happen.
You mentioned earlier on, like, to you, it's natural to network. Okay. Yeah. But you mentioned earlier on, you're like, oh, you know, you kind of led our listeners to think that everybody networks, when the fact of the matter is very few people do. Yeah. You know, so let's say we have some listeners right now who are listening to this and say, I get it. I think I can be good at this, but I've never really done it before. I don't really pay much attention to it. But I think it could work. What would be the first step that you would say to that person to start to really, use this as a tool?
Well, A, they should be going to, these networking meetings, whatever it is, they should be going to and meeting people, right? And being out and all the time. I mean, I met people all the time through networking groups or the HMAC parties you used to run in Hoboken or whatever it was, and just get out and meet people and then build those, get people that you tend to know and like, and whether in your industry or not, it doesn't matter, but start to know people. And then, listen, see who you could connect them to, right? But, it's easy to go on LinkedIn and be like, all right, I met Steve. He's really nice. Financing. Let me look for some business owners I might talk to. And start with people that you know to start to network, right? So you could go on and be like, even if you're just out of school, you'd be like, all right, who do I know on LinkedIn? Let me type in president or CEO or whatever. I'm like, oh, you know what? Uncle Nicky is a CFO somewhere. CEO somewhere. Hey, let me call him. Like, hey, Uncle Nicky, my friend Steve runs a financing company. They do this. Can I introduce you to him? And be like, yeah, great. Oh, you can start out small with just people that you're really comfortable with asking questions. And that's what I tell a lot of people in the Connective. Like, look, go to your friends that you know that are running companies and see if there's a need for what, because everyone has a need, right? I'm sure if I asked you right now, do you and Keith have a need for your company? Is it just, oh, you know what, Joe? Yeah, we're actually looking to do some
digital. I would actually articulate it differently too. I would say, Steve, tell me about your business and are there any problems that you're experiencing right now that I might know somebody who could help you? Like, that's probably the way that I would articulate it.
Everyone's dealing with something. Everyone needs something.
Everyone's dealing with something. So, right.
Or you can just, call up, start out with, people, or people you want to help to maybe that could get back to you. Right. So see whatever your industry is and be like, oh, you know what? Steve Elastic would be someone great. I could talk to. I know he could probably pass leads to me. Maybe I should be giving him a lead first, because that's what B&I is about, is giver's gain. Right. The more you give, the more you get back. Which generally happens, but a lot of times, sometimes people don't get back. But if I give you a great lead and you're like, Joe, wow, that was really great that you gave me that, then you're gonna just in your head be like, I should probably get something back to that person. So start out with just, a couple people that you're really tight with. And, if you know someone that has a company that builds websites, see who your friends are from college that are in marketing positions. Oh, my really close college friend is the head of marketing for so-and-so. Give him a call. I'm like, hey, I want to introduce you. Are you guys looking for something like this? Yeah, I am. We're actually building a new website. We need to find somebody. Oh, can I introduce you? So you know, and if it's something that works and something they need, great. If not, then move on to somebody else. But it's not hard to network. It's just a lot of people don't want to do it. And that's,
well, I think it doesn't come natural to a lot of
people. Yeah, that's just a personality thing, right? Like, I'm always like, hey, you know, I'm always telling people, just talk. Like, just, Steve, you should meet that person. And you never know. If you come across a good connector, like people always say, Joe, you're a great connector. Like, then trust me that I'm telling you to meet somebody for a reason, right?
Yeah.
Like, I'll give you a perfect example. Like, one of the, and I've been writing this book about screwing up on things. And one of the big things, I want to interview this guy. So Jay, the guy I told you about that introduced me to B&I, I was just telling a story the other day. He was one of the best connectors I met and who got me into this, right? And I always tell him that. But he at one point said, Joe, you got to meet this guy, Lance, right? He's building a beverage company and he needs graphic design, which I was doing at the time. He needs someone to do it. He's working out of his basement right now, but, you know, he's just trying to get this thing off the ground. All right, not the best lead in the world, but Jay's a friend of mine. So, yeah, I'll go meet this guy. So I set up a meeting. I wound up going to a customer like a couple days later before his meeting. And my current client was asking us for a lot more stuff. So we stayed and we're like, we got to stick with this client who's giving us more work. And sorry about Lance in his basement who has a dream about some beverage company. So I blew off the meeting. I blew it off. I was in with a client. I'm like, I got to stay here. This is definite work versus who knows what. Get out of the meeting, call. Sorry about Lance. Really sorry I missed the meeting. I got stuck at a client. You know, can we reschedule? Please call me back. No call back. 2 days later, Lance again, apologize about the meeting. You know, I got stuck with a client. Please call me back. I'd love to reschedule. Never heard from the guy again, which again, what we were talking about earlier, when you blow somebody off that day, it's a killer because obviously you said, I got something more important than what you got. Screw up. So I never got the meeting with this guy. Lance winds up being the guy that built Fuse Beverage and sold to Pepsi for $280 million a couple of years ago.
Wow.
The guy was building Fuse Beverage, F-U-Z, that you saw everywhere. And then on top of that, put salt in the wound, I met somebody like a year or two later, like after this was all done and he had sold to Pepsi. He's like, oh, yeah, you know, I heard he gave the graphic design company some equity in the company for kind of doing a – you know, doing it a little bit on the cheap when he was starting out. So whatever equity they got out of $280 million, whether it's true or not, I don't know. But still, it was like that was a huge, you know. And so now it's like, listen, I like connecting people. I know once I could see a good, time. And yeah, not everyone has that skill. I don't know if it's innate or whatever it is. Yeah. I enjoy doing it. But people can learn to do it a little bit better, but you just got to listen a lot of times and see what's it. Or if somebody tells you, go meet that person, just go meet them. Give them half an hour. I was on a call with a woman last week that, you know, she gave me half an hour. It was an outreach on LinkedIn that I did for this other company I'm working with. And she gets on the call, won't come on the video, and you can tell she's distracted and just kind of not even present on the call. And just kind of not even listen to me. And I'm like, why even, what are you wasting your time for? Why did you even give me a half an hour? You're wasting my time and you're wasting your time. You don't know what this half an hour call could lead to. I've had a couple calls. I've had like 30 calls in the last 2 weeks building this Growth 10, which is a peer advisory group that I'm doing to get people to come to the group, business owners. I've talked to all sorts of business owners about all cool stuff. And some of it's just cool to talk to. And some of it's like, you know what? Yeah, you're not a good fit for what I'm doing with that, or you're not for. But by the way, let me introduce you to this person. And there's been like 5 instances out of those 30 calls where they're not going to join my Growth 10 advisory group, but I'm connecting them to this person, or I'm connecting them there, or they've joined my connective something else.
Yeah.
So like, you know, just having conversations sometimes is good. And sometimes you see that to connect those people. But yeah, not everyone is a networker. There's people like, you know, one of my friends like will never open a door for you. I don't know why. Some people are just uncomfortable. They don't want to stick their neck out. Something bad happens. It's like, you know, people don't want to work with friends or family. Like,
yeah, I think I definitely think it's a unique skill set, so to speak. And I think you can do all different forms of it. You know, I know the issue, I would do a lot more of it. The issue I have is for the last 20 years, we don't work in New Jersey, and that's where I'm located.
Yeah.
So it's a real problem in that, you know, And to get into New York is a little bit more of an issue. The other thing is I have salespeople that work for me that's kind of what they're supposed to be doing. So, you know, the fact that, you know, I do it in a little different way when I have, like I mentioned earlier, when I have a problem, you know, I can reach out to people that I think specialize in something and say, okay, you know, so like whenever I meet people, if the conversation gets a little longer and I start to learn a little bit more about what they do for a living, I am really good at remembering those details. And so, yeah, I mean, it's just a natural skill where I'll remember everything that somebody will say in regards to what they do. And, you know, and then I kind of make a mental note of, oh, this person, if I need help in this area, I can turn to them for that, you know?
Yeah. And yeah, I'm the same way. And that's one of the reasons I started the Connective. I remember years ago, my mother was like, well, you're always involved in this stuff. I said, Mom, look, see my phone here? I said, you tell me somebody you need and I'll have somebody in my phone that I can connect you with.
Yeah.
Whatever you need. Right.
Yeah.
So, and like you, it's just remembering like who's who. So a lot of people started calling me all the time. That's part of the reason I started the Connective. They were calling me to be like, Joe, you know, everyone, who can you connect me with here? So I'm connecting. Yeah. Finally, I was like, hey, listen, Steve, I'm going to connect you, but how about giving me a little cut of the deal?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm happy to do that because they're getting a deal and I'm connecting to somebody good that they know they can trust.
And let's be clear to our listeners, you know, Joe's getting paid from the person who's selling the product, right? So, I mean, yeah, I mean, like if Joe hooks me up with somebody who needs a line of credit and it lines up, you know, I'm happy to pay Joe because I just got a client out of it. So, I mean,
and I'm getting paid for this podcast too, right? Was that in the email?
It checks in the mail, okay, but the mail's been delayed a lot lately.
Don't worry. It's a big check. but yeah, it's like, yeah, no, I don't feel bad taking a cut because like a lot, and that's one of the reasons I started Connective was because people would come to me in my marketing company and say, I got screwed by this company that sold me on some bullshit that wasn't really real. They could do that. You know, companies do that all the time, right?
Yeah.
And it's the sales guy, right? It's the guy like me, like, oh yeah, we could do that. And it's like, no, we really can't do that. And they outsource, then they get screwed up. So they would come to me too late. And the other thing is there's so many people out there that are great at like, you know, website development or technology or whatever. They built this great technology or whatever, but they're not salespeople. They're not connectors. They need someone to sell, but they're small companies. They don't have money to hire a salesperson to go out and sell for them. So it's like, okay, here, and that's what B&I and things like that work well. Here you got 35 salespeople out there opening doors for you. And now it's just that added incentive that these guys have, you know, an incentive to make that introduction because they're going to get cut of the deal too.
Well, I mean, there's something about the Connective that you're running. Maybe you should start doing more of that where you have smaller businesses where they have no salespeople come in, make presentations to your group and then say, okay, this is the details of what we do. This is what we're good at. You know, this is our market. This is, you know, why we're better than other people. This is where we're not so good at, you know, and then if you find something and we'll pay you this X amount of commission to the group, you know?
Yeah. There's phase two and three of the Connective that will do a lot of that stuff. So it's under wraps until ready to be revealed on our second phase of our podcast. So. I'm working on, you know, on the bigger platform and things like that. But right now it's working. I mean, listen, like, again, like I said, it's who you know before. Like one of the guys in the group got on the vendor list of UBS. Like how hard is it to get on the vendor list of a foreign company and a bank? And within 2-3 months is on the vendor list. That's, you know, and now primed to get a potential deal or something like that. So like there's a lot of companies that we've been able to get into just by the relationships with somebody and, you know, you have to have a good company, you know, like, and that's the process where I'm like, listen, if you're not going to do a good job, you know, you're not going to be in this group, you know? And I have people, I had a friend of mine that I had a project that somebody was looking for. Hey, Joe, do you have something for this? Yeah, I got something for this. I called him. Hey, I got this deal. It's with, it was like Liberty Mutual. It's a marketing thing. I don't want to get too specific, but it's like, hey, yeah, here's the head of marketing for like the tri-state area that needs this. And he never followed up. Like 2 weeks later, it's like, hey, how'd that deal go? Oh, your friend never followed up with it. I'm like, so So I was like, you know what? You're not even in the group before you even start the group. You got an introduction to somebody and you made us look bad by, and it wasn't even, it was money for you. And like, you know, and so it just, and this guy I knew for 10 years. I'm like, you're out. You're not. I don't care if you're my brother, my cousin, my best friend. Like, if you're not going to do a good job, like, you know, because it's our reputation, my reputation, the connective's reputation, every member of that group reputation to make sure that we do a good job.
All right. Well, listen, that was good stuff. You know, if you, to our listeners, if you, you know, can do a little networking and look at it as another tool in your back pocket, if you have a smaller company, you know, that, you know, maybe you can take some of Joe's advice and really use that as an important tool. Now, certainly there's networking to friends and there's networking to people you know. I mean, certainly there's also networking back to your customers. It's something that I think we all forget about. Go back to your customers, ask for, you know, who else could use your product or service. You know, just constantly be going back to your client. I know on my calendar, I have it every 3 to 4 months. I have a reminder that comes up and reminds me to go back to our existing clients because our clients are our best referrals.
Well, one step further, Steve, is like, why aren't you looking at your clients, right? You're servicing them. You're doing a good job for them. Who are you connecting them to, right? Think about it. You're working on your client. And they're paying you a monthly fee and whatever. You say, hey, by the way, so-and-so client, I looked up, and this is going through LinkedIn and seeing, oh, you sell this? Well, this person buys that. Hey, by the way, I know that person that's on the buying end, and you connect them to your client. You're like, hey, I just bought you a deal. You know, I don't have to. It's not part of what I do. I just have, hey, you guys should talk. And all of a sudden, you open a door for your client, and they get a $50,000, $100,000, $200,000 deal, and they're paying you. They're like, how much more do they want to keep paying you by doing above and beyond? That's what I always try to do. Like, when I had HMAG, you know, the magazine in Hoboken, every client that advertised with us, I tried to make sure I connected them. Somebody could use their service. My goal was to pay for their advertising every year, right? If I could get them enough business to pay for their advertising, they're going to continue to advertise with me. And yeah. I did almost every client. That's why we'd have parties at the different bars and stuff, because I would bring 100 people to that restaurant that advertised, spending the money. That was their advertising for the year by having those parties. But then, you know, whoever else was, the real estate company, I probably gave a real estate company $5 million in deals easily, you know, from connections I made. They've never stopped paying. They're still advertising in HMAC 10 years later, you know, so. Connect your clients to people that could be potential customers for them. How good of a feather in your cap is that for your clients? So
all good stuff, Joe. Yep. So I'd like to thank Joe so very much for coming on to today's podcast. If you like today's podcast, please feel free to share it with a friend and also subscribe on your favorite podcasting app. And of course, if you're looking for a line of credit for your business, you can call us at 862-207-4118 or visit our website at fscreditline.com. Joe, if anyone wants to get in touch with you, how would they go about doing that?
So you could send an email to joe@theconnective.me. Or you could give me a call, 201-410-8282. Always happy to talk and help people with learning how to network or make introductions, or someone has a cool product or service that they can't seem to get sold and want to get some introductions. I'll talk to them as well.
Yeah, all good stuff. And if our listeners are interested in getting any like new ideas, new business ideas, new how to run a company, I tweet daily about lessons for business owners. At S Halasnik, it's S-H-A-L-A-S-N-I-K, and really good stuff, I think, that we had today from Joe. And Joe, just again, thanks for coming on board.
No, thanks for having me, Steve. Appreciate it.
So, you know, thank you for listening, and also for just everyone, remember that networking is one of the important tools that people are just not doing. And with all the tools that are out there right now, and with Joe's advice, you know, it's just a great opportunity for you to expand your business and the people you know and enjoy doing it. So everybody have a great day. Please stay safe. And summer's right around the corner. I think we're all looking forward to that. Have a great day.